Did you shoot, or was that them?
Oh, geez, they swear. Inside, and each day I'm kind of on a dreaming about you. Oh, yeah, got this world class view. The shoe that I think about every time my mind's on it. The shoe that I think about every time I feel alone. The shoe that I call it the face of something real.
Nice. Oh, yeah. I like this.
But the night shift till late in the p.m. I'm California dreaming.
Yo guys, what's going on? Mxrsden here and welcome back to the YouTube channel. Yes, today we finally have some super people content. It has taken me so long to edit this video and I've been working really hard on the next super people video that will be coming out as well. But in the gameplay, I am joined with one of my good friends, somoh. His channel link will be down in the description below. And in this gameplay, I run SEEKER. Now, SEEKER is an absolutely crazy character and I'll be going over all of his abilities and his perks at the end of the video, so make sure to stick around for that. Anyways, with all that being said, I'll catch you guys at the end of the vid. Enjoy the gameplay.
I got amplify straight away.
Military's looking good. Military's looking good. What are your thoughts on this?
Sounds good.
Alright. I reckon land my building that I pinged. It's just like a huge shed with a bunch of loot. I'm gonna drop now so I can get in early. Yeah, my seeker map's going off. I can see people all around. There's no gun up here. I'm gonna go inside, man. Yeah, one guy's bottom floor of our building.
Hang on, I got amplifier. Let me just see. Yeah, he's right below us. My third person is. Yeah, he's coming up.
Nice, I'm with you, I'm with you, I'm with you.
He got a body bag. He's dead.
Oh, yeah, dead. He's out. Yeah, he's out of it. Down one. On me. Well played. Good shit, bro. First blood. This guy had a heroic cock. Oh my god.
What ammo do I take? I take 7.
Oh my gosh, he had a heroic weapon too. Level 5 backy, level 3 vest, level 2 helmet. I needed all of that. I legit have 2 carcs on me. Nothing else.
Survival bonus.
I'm confident, pal, but not that confident. I'm grabbing an ump. Gold capsule? No one got? Nice. I'll take. Oh, I have my heartbeat sensor too.
Who are you?
I got a Seeker, yeah. They're the only 2 characters that get a heartbeat.
Yeah, one, right in front of me, right in front of me.
Yeah, same.
Right in front of me, close. Fuck, I just did that. Just clicked on my fucking heartbeat as well.
Back up to me. I'm gonna have a quick. Yeah, I hear him. Close.
Okay. Popping a power bar. Is he still close?
Yeah.
Nice.
Oh, fuck, you mainly rinsed me, bro.
Yeah.
Alright, good shit. Alright, bro. I dropped a pretty darn good
survival bonus.
Did the scope there?
Projectile. Oh, I don't think so. Acquired. Oh, I could make heroic. Yeah, I'm gonna do it. Oh, yeah, I got sniped up.
Yeah. up on the hill, 40, I think.
Yeah, oh, terrible, Nick. Terrible, Nick. We're good, we're good.
Oh, yeah, close, close. On me. Right in front, right in front.
Like, how close?
Like, can 10 you ping? Like, right above this hill, like, hill line. Close. Maybe at your trees.
Up
maybe
there.
At your trees.
Up there, up there. Live ping, live ping. And his mate's up here.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Fuck. This tree's doing me no justice. Up on that hill. I'm fucking healing. Fuck, he's still getting me through the tree? I need to go. I'm so low.
Downed.
I'm healing.
I need your help. I need your help.
I'm taking a power bar.
Other guys close.
Coming, coming, coming.
Down there, down there.
Tagged a bit.
How much is he tagged?
Oh, probably like 30, tagged him 30. Got a couple bullets. He's behind the tree too.
Nice, nice. Good shit, good shit.
I'm healing. Oh, I don't have any heals. I need to go to his body.
Finally a four times, bro.
Yeah, just cover me. Oh, right in front of us. What the hell?
Where are we at?
Right here, behind this rock. Drop the bomb. He's legging. He's still behind the bomb. Still behind. I'm gonna wrap right side.
Alright, I'll wrap left.
Still can't see him. Still can't see him.
I can.
Got him.
We're never safe.
Get behind
oh,
this
guy, guy
oh,
right in the open. Nice shot, bro. I missed twice. Alright, we move. Wrap with me. Wrap with me left. Wrap with me left. They're fighting up there. I'm gonna wrap over here.
Yeah, we got low ground. Pretty fucking shit.
Nah, but we come behind them. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, I'm wrapping with you.
Pop your power bars. I see him. I see him. They're in this radius. They're fighting. They're fighting. We third party now. Go.
Go, go, go. Cover fire
right. I push. Push. 2v1. 2v1. That's a burner, baby. That's a burner. Let's go.
Let's go.
Let's go, dude. Good shit. Great game. Great game. Yo.
Easy dubs.
Bro, we played that well. Not gonna lie. We played that really fucking well.
I know.
Holy yikes. Shit. Let's go, man. Just let's like go. That. Alrighty guys, here we are in the Super People training grounds. This is kind of like the Super People barracks, essentially, where you can test out a bunch of different characters and their abilities, and you can also try out all the weapons with all different attachments and everything like that. So, extremely useful to be able to test all these things, especially before going out into Orb Island, where you gotta compete against everyone, especially in the tournament. But we're gonna go through Seeker's abilities here. I'm gonna show you all of his perks. Now, you would have been able to see most of these in the video, but I really just wanted to touch on all of them and show what they can do at full capacity. So we'll jump into the red perks to begin with. Now, this is just the standard perk that every class gets. If you've played Super People before, you know that depending on what class you select before you jump into Orb Island, you will be given a designated gun. And it usually varies depending on your class. With sniper, it's mainly snipers, as you can imagine. But there's also DMRs in there as well. When it comes to Seeker, he can get shotguns, SMGs, that sort of stuff. And it's extremely useful to have this perk that buffs the damage. It doesn't always go up to 15%. Sometimes it goes to 20 or even 30, depending on the gun. So for level 1, you get a extra 7% increase in shotgun damage. For level 2, a 10% increase. And for level 3, a 15%. 15%. Now moving on to the next perk is cover fire right. So for level 1 you get a 40% increase in leaning angle and leaning speed when leaning towards the right. Now you'll be able to see here that when I lean towards the left it's only a little bit, but when I lean towards the right I fully hunch down. Now when you're behind a small piece of cover, I would say that this is probably not the best perk, because as you can see you're showing more of yourself, more than what you usually would if you didn't have this perk. But if you're behind like a big piece of cover, you might be able to show like a smaller fraction of your body when peeking. But like I said, it's not the greatest perk, because you do show more of yourself and that is a bigger risk. But behind bigger cover, perhaps you might be able to show a smaller fraction depending on how you do it. For level 2, you get an extra 10% defense when leaning, and for level 3, an extra 10% damage when leaning. That is extremely OP considering that leaning is used a lot in this game when people are hiding behind cover. Now moving on to the third ability, Border Control. It's a very standard perk. So for level 1, you get up to 10% defense when near the Ice Storm boundary. For level 2, a 15% defense. And for level 3, you get a 20% defense. Now this is extremely useful in the tournament because you often find that you're running from the Ice Storm. And in the tournament, it does a lot more damage now. So it's good to have that extra percentage of defense when moving in with the zone. Now moving on to the green perks, we've got Home Ground Mountains. Now for level 1, you get an extra 5% damage in rocky terrain or when taking cover behind trees. For level 2, an extra 7%, and for level 3, an extra 10%. Now this is an extremely useful perk because as you can, well you can't see because you can't see the map, but usually on Orb Island I would say about 70 to 75% of it is covered in rocky terrain and trees, and just being out around the trees that you're usually taking cover behind, especially when the zone does not close around any infrastructure and you're stuck hiding behind rocks and trees and that sort of stuff, it's really, really useful having that extra 10% damage. Alrighty guys, now moving on to the second green perk, projectile tracking. Now this really speaks for itself to be honest, but for level 1 you can see the trajectory of throwables, for level 2 you take 25% less damage received from throwables, and for level 3 you take 50% less damage. So again, really speaks for itself, but basically frags won't do as much to you, which is again extremely useful when you're out in Orb Island. Now this next perk is probably arguably the best perk that Seeker gets. It's called Hostiles Detected. And essentially, you'll be able to see on your little mini map in the bottom left, as well as when you open up just the large map. But essentially what it does is for level 1, it detects the location of one nearby enemy within a 75 meter radius. For level 2, it's within a 100 meter radius. And for level 3, it's within a 150 meter radius. So essentially, it just automatically pings off on your map, letting you know the vicinity of enemies that are within that radius. And it's extremely, extremely OP because the truth is, when you're moving out of a compound of houses and you're moving on to another compound, it'll be able to notify you if there's any boys there. And basically, it will have an 80 second cooldown for level 3 as well, as compared to the 100 second cooldown when level 1. So the truth is, if you're kind of stuck in zone, but you've got some meds on you and you can last and you see that people are in front of you, just kind of wait out that 80 seconds, wait till it goes off again. Hopefully it doesn't and you can know that you're safe to then push in. Now moving on to the blue perks here. So for level 1, for landing zone scan, it locates enemies that have landed near your landing zone for 5 minutes. Now obviously they can't really flesh that out anymore as you level up. So for level 2 you get a 5% movement speed increase, and for level 3 a 10% movement speed increase. But this is usually the perk that you get for level 1 when you're first dropping in. So as you would know if you play Super People, when you're using a class, you're always level 1 when you jump into a game. So you always get one of these perks on one bar. And most of the time, it's either landing zone scan for Seeker or home ground mountains. Now, moving on to the second blue perk, we have the heartbeat sensor. Now, the heartbeat sensor is just fantastic. Now, if you've played the sniper class, you know that he also gets to indulge in this fantastic perk. But essentially for level 1, what it does is the heartbeat sensor will be acquired. Now, I think it's like a 5 to 10 meter radius at this point, which isn't very useful. But for level 2, you get an extra 10 meters to see in that detection range. And for level 3, an extra 20 meters. So extremely useful. But when you go to level 1 here, you can see that I can see him, and then I keep backing up, and I can't see him here. But when I increase that range further and walk back, I can see people like all the way over there. So when you have the hostiles detected perk go off and you can see that someone's in that vicinity, you can then use your heartbeat sensor to narrow down exactly where they are. It also tracks their movement through walls and through everything, so you know exactly if they're pushing you and if you'll possibly have an angle to open fire on them. So yeah, extremely OP perk, and Sniper gets it as well. So there are some perks that do cross over with other classes, and the heartbeat sensor is one of them. Now moving into the last perk of the video, we have Molotov Traps. So essentially what this does is it upgrades all of your Molotov cocktails into Molotov Traps. Now these explode when enemy players come nearby. So you only get to carry two of these deployable traps, but you automatically gain two as soon as you get the perk. And it also increases your backpack weight capacity. So essentially carrying these Molotov traps does not add any weight to your backpack, which is fantastic, to be honest. And when you move on to level 2, you get to hold 3 deployable traps and an extra 1 meter trigger radius on the trap itself. And for level 3, you can hold up to 5 deployable traps and an extra 2 meters on the trigger radius, which is fantastic. So if I pull out the Molotov trap just here and I throw it in the vicinity of this guy, now it does bounce, which is extremely annoying, especially if you're trying to set it up in a specific spot. But as you can see, it goes off here and it pretty well does a lot of damage if they're, you know, standing in it. And it does, you can see the spread here, it's quite large, so it's going to take them a while to get away from it. But it does about 80 to 90 damage, which can get your opposition player really, really low before you can then push in. So now that we've gone over all of the perks of Seeker, and you can see why all these perks are just extremely useful, especially when you're in solos, it gives you intel on so many of the players that are in your game when you're pushing compounds, so you can pretty well avoid gunfights if you want to, or you have extra intel when you push in on gunfights, so you basically have an advantage over every other player, because you know where they are, but they don't know where you are. Now, we will go over the ultimate ability of Seeker, but before I do that, I'll just show you what you fully get when you're max level in Seeker. So you get an extra 50% damage dealt with all guns, an extra 30% movement speed and parkour speed, and an extra 60 health. That is with all the perks, keep in mind. But let's take these all away, and we'll go to, like, I'd say level 10, where you can get the slide here, which is Seeker's main ultimate ability. Now, it's essentially just 3 slides. You can use like 1 or 2, but if you don't use the third one, after about 5 seconds, the cooldown will start and it will take, 70 seconds in order for that quick slide to come back once again. Now, quick slide is best used when you're in an open field, someone starts shooting at you, and you can get behind cover quickly. And it's also best used when you get someone low and they're hiding behind something and you want to push. Kind of like Strike Force. Obviously, you use Strike Force when you push up on people that you've got low, or you just want to WK people. It's really useful in that scenario as well. But we'll show you what it does here. Now, you don't change direction when you're sliding by using A, D, or S, or anything like that. You simply change direction just by moving your mouse. So if I slide here, move my mouse, slide here, move my mouse. So as you can see, we can do like the zigzags, and I'll show you the best scenario that I would use this in. So for example, you get someone low and they get behind that cover there. What I would do is I would slide there to begin with in order to cut off the angle that I am visible at so they can't see me, and then I would make my second slide into the open and kind of shoot at them from behind. So then they gotta turn around, they gotta lock on their crosshair, and by the time they do that, they should pretty well already be dead. So I'll show you what this looks like. I'll slide here and slide out here and essentially get them when they're in the corner. So that is the best way, I would say, to push people that are hiding behind cover. Extremely overpowered, but the best thing about this game is that most ultimate abilities in this game are extremely OP, and it kind of gives the game a sense of balance in its own unique and weird way. But I love Seeker, and I've been running him for pretty much the whole entire final beta. But anyways, that's the full rundown on Seeker. I really hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, don't forget to leave a like, and also let me know in the comment section below what sort of Super People content you would like to see going forward. I know my next video will be about the Super Tournament, and I'm extremely excited to show you guys how that has gone for me so far. And also, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit the bell to see some more amazing Super People content coming soon. And finally, like I said earlier in the video, don't forget to show Somoh some love. His channel link is in the description below. Alrighty, I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace out.
Vodka, vodka, take another sip, lying in your bed.